Okay, we're here going to do the Kenwood model 11G. Little Steely Dan on here. Try to show you some of the functions. You have this EQ, which this one's missing, the levers broke off, but you can have it on. Then you can adjust your self EQ because you don't have balancing trebles. You do have a loudness button. Right now I have the EQ on, but I have it set at zero. The loudness is off. Get a song started here, and I'm probably blocking a little bit of the one speaker, so. Let me move. Here's with loudness on.
Times are hard. When you need a bit of love, cause your man is out of town.
Typical smile.
That's the time to get me running, and you know I'll be around.
I'm a fool to do your dirty work, oh yeah. I don't want to do your dirty work no more.
We were up to about a third of the power there. I was up to number four on there. But yeah, you've got the timer. You have your AM, FM, your phono 1, phono 2, your aux input, mono stereo loudness. You have all your different Dolby sources. But there's not a lot, there's no Dolby stations anymore. So mic mixing, get your power levels, stuff like that. So. You can do three sets of speakers. I'm not sure if you can run all three together. I'd have to look that up. It depends on how much impedance you're putting on the amps. But yeah, so there's the Kenwood Model 11G. I'll flip over to the 9600. Okay, over to the Kenwood KR-9600. Gonna play the same song. So you can have sound test. There are other videos with this one already doing sound tests. So you guys kind of know what it sounds like, but just wanted to do it again here, doing the same song. This one you still have separate controls on tones and stuff. Your deflection on the meter, if you want it to 3 watts, to 200 watts. You got all your inputs, your different modes. This one has two loudness controls, 1 and 2. Adds a different amount of, tone. A little more bass there. Controls are straight up.
So you find yourself somebody. When you need a bit of love, cause your man is out of town. That's the time to get me running, and you know I'll be around.
I'm a fool to do your dirty work. Oh yeah.
So controls were clean. So yeah, I'm not sure I was going to come out on a single microphone input off the camera. But yeah, so there's the KR-9600. And I will set up the little bit smaller units. Okay, now we're doing the Kenwood KR-6400 receiver. The bad thing about these is when the phono's on, the lights are out. Only the lights, it's kind of like some of those Sansui's. When you're on the radio stations. So anyway, let's still doing some Steely Dan. Tone controls are straight up. Loudness is on. We're about 1/3 of the way. So the KR-6400. Okay, I'm back with the Kenwood KR-3600. Still the Steely Dan going. So, probably getting tired of Steely Dan, but it's the record I had out. This is a 22 watt Purcinella receiver. What's cool about this is even when it's on phono, the radio backlight stays lit up. So yeah, source, or if you're in a tape monitor, play tapes, phono, aux, FM, AM. So yeah, KR-3600. 22 watt per channel receiver. That's gonna be it today. Got to head out doing the night shift this week, so 6 p.m. to 6 a.m. and it's 4:30 already. Got to get a shower and go to work. All right, you guys enjoy the rest of the evening. See you.